Hi everybody, my name's Matt Elliott and I'm here at RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon today to show you a brand new trailer that we just got from Keystone. This is a Hideout 29DFS. This is a very popular design and it has the double bunks. And you'll see inside this has got a tremendous amount of space for a family or for gear if you're putting other things in those bunks. You know, you don't have to put kids in bunks, you can put fishing poles in there. So I like that. One of the things I want to say about this trailer is that it's a really affordable trailer. In fact, if you look at the way the used market is right now, it'd be easier for you to buy this than most used trailers. Another thing is that I love about this trailer is that it's a sheet metal exterior. A lot of times people kind of want the fiberglass because it looks newer and it's fancier, but this is by far the most reliable exterior. It just doesn't deteriorate in weather over time. My dad's got a sheet metal boat that's older than I am and it looks like brand new. So I really like this. Let's take a look around this rig and I'll just point out a few things. First of all, this does have the power tongue jack on it. It also has power stabilizer jacks on all four corners. If we look in here, it's got a massive storage compartment, so you can carry too much stuff if you want. We go over here, we see that we've got a big power awning, and that's really nice. You just push a button and it comes right out, and also it's got the LED light strip, so it really lights up your area. You'll also notice this trailer has good ground clearance. It gets up off the ground, and so if you're pulling into more remote areas or rougher country, you don't have to worry so much about getting hung up on stuff. And we look back here, this has a little outside galley. A lot of times when people say they want a rear kitchen or an outside galley, you almost have to have either a bunkhouse or a rear bathroom design so they have some room to design this in. And so here, what I love about this is it's got an actual cooktop. So many outside kitchens we see don't have really any cooktop built in. Maybe a gas grill you can hang on, but here I can go ahead and make my pork and beans and stuff out here, and I like that. I want to be able to cook that way. Do have a little refrigerator, which is dynamite. Also, you take a look and we have these new solid steps. These steps are worth their weight in gold because when you walk in and out of the trailer doesn't bounce up and down. The weight is on the ground. They're very stable. If you have sore knees or ankles or anything, you don't have to worry about things wobbling underfoot. It's very, very solid. Now, as you walk around the backside, I want to point out that this has a ladder. Ladders are getting to be somewhat scarce in the industry. A lot of manufacturers don't design the roofs to be walked on, but a walkable roof is really important because I can maintain my roof seals, I can clean debris off there, I can make sure there's nothing in on top of my slide like a pine cone or a tree branch that would interfere when I want to bring the slide in. So having a ladder is very important. This certainly is a good idea. Let's walk around over here. Now, this one has a big double slide, and one of the things you'll notice if you ever look closely at slide outs, there's different types of mechanisms. This one has the rack and pinion slide out. I'm a big fan of this system because there's no hydraulics, no cables, no adjustments really needed. It just goes straight out and straight back. They're the most stable and reliable type of slide out that you'll find. Let's take a look inside. So now in there, inside the trailer, the first thing that we see right here is our double bunks. And the thing that's great about these being at this location is that, you know, the kids are out of the middle of the trailer. So one thing about little kids, they don't go to bed unless they have a place to be. This gives them a spot to put their stuff and have their little place where they go and they will fall asleep. At the same time, I don't have to put kids in here. I can throw fishing poles and hunting rifles and cargo and duffel bags and whatever I want in that space. So it's very, very versatile to have bunk beds. Another thing that's nice about this, it's got a really nice bathroom and it does have a bathtub because the likelihood that you're going to have some kids in here, you want to have a bathtub to wash them up with. We've got a really neat design here in the living space. We have a jackknife sofa here. Jackknives are nice because they're all storage underneath. It's located right across from the TV. Got a huge TV with a media player here and then an electric fireplace. I love these electric fireplaces because Now I can heat my trailer with electricity and I don't have to listen to my furnace blowing. This is very ambient, it's nice. So that's a big deal here. Another thing that's incredible about this trailer is that we've got a big refrigerator right here. Take a look at this thing. Got a massive fridge. You can really load up in here. Also, we've got the three burner stove. We've got an oven. Down here, even got a vacuum cleaner. One thing I want to point out about this particular design is that this kitchen is up here in the front corner. So many of the trailers you look at, the kitchen's going to arc out into the main living area. They come out this way and they kind of get in the way. With this one, I'm not in front of the TV walking back and forth and people aren't walking through my kitchen. I can socialize with folks without having them get in my mad science lab over here. Another really incredible detail about this is the horseshoe dining area. This gives you seating that can be all the way around for a bigger family. But one other thing that's neat about this is I can also take this middle section out and have it be a face-to-face dinette. So I can actually do it either way. The other thing, of course, is that you have all storage. This freestanding table will fold down to coffee table height. So if I want to put some chips and stuff out in front of the couch while I'm watching the game, I can move it over there or even take it outside. Last thing I want to show you is the bathroom, the bedroom, excuse me. So we look in here, we've got a nice, really big queen walk-around bed. We've got good hanging storage, and there's actually another storage cabinet on the corner here. Most trailers don't have that additional storage. And of course, the bed lifts up and it's all storage under there. So that is a quick look at the 29 FKDS Hideout, the 2022. I hope you enjoyed the video. I'd love to show it to you in person. And I'm here to answer any questions that you have. So you can reach me directly. My name is Matt Elliott. You can reach me at 541-954-8495. You have a great day.